With every second year, on average, frost events are significant enough to wipe out tens of millions of dollars of WA crops. So it is no surprise that the state's grain growers place frost management at the top of their research, development and extension priority list. Currently, growers do not have accurate, up-to-date information on how present and emerging farming practices change the severity of frost events. Dr. Ben Biddulph from the Department of Agriculture and Food WA and his team are working in this area to determine the susceptibility of crops to frost in WA under different farming practices.
So the main work that's getting run at this site is the benchmarking of the wheat and barley varieties for their frost performance values, so basically their relative susceptibility to frost. We've also got other work looking at how different agronomic management practices can change frost damage, so we're looking at nitrogen and seeding rate. We also have a little bit of work on this site looking at potash nutrition with Murdoch University, looking at how potash nutrition and other nutrition factors can influence the relative susceptibility to frost. We also have some work with some external collaborators with UWA, looking at spatially mapping the spatial and temporal variation in frost across the actual trial sites and across the plots.
Dr. Dion Nicol, researcher from DAFWA, is looking at the implications of agronomic factors, including nitrogen, variety and seeding rate, and how that changes frost susceptibility.
For this, we have four times the sowing within each set of experiments, and we're looking at varying seed rates of four major varieties, and then looking at high and low nitrogen, looking at trying to change the architecture of the crop from a sort of more spread development through to a more synchronous canopy where flowering is much tighter, and then see how that changes the frost susceptibility. We also have a series of nitrogen experiments, which is looking at later applications of low through to high, very high rates of nitrogen, and seeing if we can see any changes in frost susceptibility with those. And also looking at developing more improved physiological measurements to try and pinpoint processes that may indicate tolerance or susceptibility.
The extensive trial work also looks at how plants respond after a frost event. Brenton Leskey explains.
So we're looking at two main methods here that plants can compensate from frost damage. Firstly is looking at increases in grain size, and secondly looking at retillering. And we're looking to quantify a plant's capacity to respond in those two measures. So when a whole spike is lost due to frost, does the plant send up new tillers? Or if part of the spike is frosted, does it increase grain size through its remaining grains to help compensate for that loss in grain number?
There's 20 to 30 trials nationally conducted each year with complex and multiple variables measured throughout the year. As Dr. Karen Reeves explains, this makes the role of a biometrician a very important one.
So the role of a biometrician in the project is to underpin the scientific rigour of the research and to ensure that any treatment differences we find, that we can conclude that they're real.
Out of the benchmarking trials, we produce the frost performance values, and they're uploaded annually onto MBT for the new wheat varieties as they come through. For the agronomic work, that's just in the first early stages of that work, so it'll be 2 or 3 years before we actually start to present that work to industry. But essentially that will go out through the normal extension channels in collaboration with GRDC and regional updates across Western Australia.